Hello everyone, welcome back to another video on the channel. Today we're going to be discussing the fifth round of CDS and the final round of CDS. Mistakes that I've made, going over battles, plans for the next season of CDS, and how I felt about CDS overall. And we'll be discussing the new builds, or build I should say, that's already been done. I do plan on using it for the next season. Other than that, I'm going to be going over, again, mistakes that I've made, how I felt about my battles, the calls, all the small and big things for the fifth round and the sixth round of CDS. So, that being said, without further ado, let's get right into it. And please, smash that like button if you haven't already, and subscribe if you like this kind of content, and let's get right into the video. So starting it off, for our first battle in round 5, I was going against my good buddy, Eureka. He's a phenomenal driver, but as you can see, starting off, we entered on my screen. There is, because of Carrick being desync, I hit him and the judges saw me hit him, but it was not enough of much of a contact for him to spin. So coming into the inside clip 1, we're going in entry. I have to sort of push off a little bit and stay back because I don't want to have to hit him again due to the desync. See, as you can see right there, I hit him again, so I had to take that into consideration for the next battle. As you can see here, I'm leading. I was like, so because of that, I'm faster than him, I jumped him off the gun. The camera quality doesn't really do much good justice, or not quality, the angle doesn't do much justice, but back there, he crashed into the wall, causing him to zero out. So I knew all I had to do was just put down a solid line, and then that's going to be an automatic victory for me. But phenomenal driver, he's a good friend of mine, and I hope to battle him someday in the future. My second battle into the top 16, I was going against XO Quacky, sorry if I pronounced that wrong, but as you can see, he got the jump on me quite a bit. I should have honestly taken the restart, but I didn't, and as you can see, I went a little too aggressive and I hit the wall, therefore I zeroed out, and he automatically had an advantage over me going into the second round. In my perspective of it, initially, there was a little bit of lag. That's why it was a delay on the jump. But either way, it was still a jump, and I should have taken a restart marker anyway. But as you can see here in the second round of the battle, I just had to throw it in as much as I can, be aggressive, go saucy boy with it, because I knew I was going to lose anyway. As you can see, he's perfect proximity, just not right where he is right now. He knows he's automatically gonna win, so he's just playing conservative. I do drop 2 tires coming out of the outside zone 2. Unfortunate for me though. So now on to the final round of CDS. We are going to be doing the new map that was recently released 2 weeks ago. Unfortunately, coming into the battles, I was automatically placed in the top 16 because my opponent did not show up. So therefore, I decided to take this lap into consideration and try to make it a practice lap, if you will, trying to, make sure to take notes on where I need to be, how I need to do certain things in order to get to each zone and clipping point as much as possible. Because, I was, the next battles ahead, I knew were going to be some very difficult battles because you'll see down in later in the video, I'm going to the top 8. So, but yeah, this is my Byron, and that's what happened. My next battle up was with the number 1 qualifier, Bijun. I'm pretty sure I faced him in the second round of CDS on Red Ring. However, he is a very good driver. He was very consistent. Unfortunately, though, as you can see here, he did put a slight bit of a gap on me, but I managed to close it in. He did exactly where he needed to be, went a little wide coming near to the second outside zone, but he held it, dropping I believe 1 or 2 tires off coming into the inner sweeper right here. You can see he comes all the way out, dropping another tire and then missing the entirety of the inside zone, giving me the advantage overall. And then as we switch it up, I'm leading, he's chasing. I knew what the mistakes he made. I knew what I needed to do. So coming into the initiation here, you'll see in a second, I knew, I heard it, I had pulled a bit of a gap on him, which was phenomenal in my part because that means I could, he has to recover ground and sacrifice as much angle and, areas as possible in order for him to try to maintain the win. Therefore, I had to try to put down at least a 99 plus qualifying run into battles, and as you can see, that's exactly what I did, and it made me get the win. This next battle is up against my good friend Coop. He won the event overall, becoming first place in the entirety of CDS. He's a phenomenal driver, very fast, very consistent. Big fan of James Dean, I'm guessing. But as you can see, hitting the inside zone, coming on initiation, coming very close to the out of bounds marker, but just manages to hold it very close. As you can see, he's pulling on me quite a bit. I'm having to sacrifice half of my line just to be able to maintain and keep up with him even a little bit. I do close in the gap a little bit, but however, I struggled very, very much to just stay with him. As you can see, so he had the advantage. Switching sides though, as you can see, it's going to, he obviously has the advantage. So that being said, I'm pretty sure he knew exactly what he needed to do. We called it, we knew we were gonna battle each other, so I wanted to make it go on for the ages, at least for this one. So I was like, I'm gonna put down whatever I can, see whatever happens. So as you can see, I missed the inside clip coming into the initiation. I swing a little too wide going into the second outer zone. As you can see, he's right on my door. It has the exact proximity where it needs to be. Very consistent, as I said. Goes off a little bit, but they did say that counted. That did not count against us. So as you can see, I just tried to put down the best possible lead chase or lead run I possibly could, but it wasn't enough, so he got the win. Now, overall, CDS is a very, very, I'd say, productive and good competition server. It's not, I wouldn't say it's biased. There are some things that could be better. There obviously are things that need to be fixed. Everything that needs must has to be fixed somewhere or another in anything. But overall, it is an amazing server. I love the competition. It pushes me to be better. And overall, it is, again, just an amazing, amazing thing to try and do. If you do want to try, I highly recommend it because they are good. A lot of amazing drivers from everywhere. But what this means in the future for next season, I do plan on using a new build. I'm going to stick with that one build because, as you can see, for the fifth round, I switched cars. I did it for the fourth round, I believe, as well, going into using my S15. Therefore, I'm going to be using my S13. And then, however, I do have a backup car just in case. But I do want to become a better driver. I do want to push myself to be better. And next season, I do want to attempt to make the, at least somewhere in the top three. I did finish 8th overall in points, which is not entirely bad considering the fact that I came in late. I missed the entirety of the very first round. it's pushed me as a become a better driver through all the amount of, driving I've done over the past few years. And the level of competitions from the very bottom to basic street comps all the way up to, professional level comps like this. So I'm very grateful of all the experiences that I've been through, and I'm very happy to be able to go doing these sort of things and being able to just push myself to become a better driver. As you can see on the screen, this will be the car that I'm using for the next season. But anyway, that's all I gotta say. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Again, smash the like button. Leave a like, smash the like button, leave a comment, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.